Ladies and gentlemen, Silent Mike back with another topic of the day. Today we're going to cover the carnivore diet. Before we dig in, be sure to follow me, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch. We're streaming 5 times a week. My podcast, 50% Facts, is now live. iTunes, Spotify, anywhere you want to go. Give this thing a thumbs up. Subscribe. Let's dig into the carnivore diet. Now looking on one end, I think the carnivore diet got some popularity because a couple people obviously popular on the internet, I believe it was led mostly by Sean Baker, being on Joe Rogan's podcast, made it quite popular, and diets in general are very extreme. Our society is very extreme. If you say black and white, you're gonna be a lot more popular than if you say gray area and spectrum. And the carnivore diet is probably the most refined, simplest form of a diet. All I eat is red meat. Compliance is another big piece. And if you just eliminate every part of your diet out, except for the carnivore, it seems very simple. Sean Baker's deadlifted 500 pounds plus, maybe 585. He's quite muscular. He's a little bit older, and he's talked about his blood markers improving over time. So these factors all combined, I can see why some people may find the carnivore diet a little enticing to at least give it a go, right? Red meat, a lot of protein, good fats. We found over time since the 90s that good fats, there's nothing wrong with eating dietary cholesterol, that it has little to maybe no effect on our actual cholesterol. And it can help regulate hormones, repair body tissue. Protein's very important. Eliminating carbs if you're not doing, you know, perhaps, you know, endurance type sports. If you're trying to just live a happy, healthy life, lift a little bit of weight, look a little bit better, be a little bit leaner, it seems like the carnivore diet is the perfect answer for you based on some of these blood results that people got. And I think they did it, you know, maybe tested their results 6 months into the diet, and then also maybe a year into the diet, and there was improvements in some of the markers. Now, counter to that, many people obviously think micronutrients are gonna be very important with vegetables and fruits. The carnivore diet society, we'll call them, I don't know if that's something official or not, but they say that you can get majority of those you need from the red meat itself, because those animals themselves are eating the plants, and I don't know if that science works out exactly if you transfers through the absorption and the digestion. Look, I'm no scientist, I'm just going off what I hear and what I read. Nutritionists are gonna say probably add some variety into your diet, and that red meat still, even though we not can't really tell, the issue is that when you're studying diet over long term, it's hard to keep different humans compliant. And you have to monitor every single thing they eat and every single thing they do to show or to eliminate all the variables to allow you to determine that this food or this type of diet over 10 years causes this or helps with this, if that makes sense. That's why you do a lot of studies on rats, because you get to feed them, you get to control them, and a lot of their physiological markers tend to do similar things to what a human can do. But you can't put 10 people into a cage for 10 years and feed them red meat only and see what their blood markers may do or may not do. My personal opinion on the topic is just that, sure, your markers may improve over 6 months, but we don't know how or what you were doing beforehand. If you're eating Twinkies all the time, Oreos, sitting on the couch, and maybe just lifting weights, doing nothing, and now all of a sudden you got leaner because you're in a calorie deficit because you eliminated every food source around the world besides red meat, which you're more than likely gonna get leaner. It's really hard to overeat on just ribeye, especially if you're a larger human being, a more muscular man. It's gonna be very difficult. So of course your markers are gonna improve on the short term, but improving your markers on the short term is not what we're going for. We're looking for stability. We're looking for homeostasis over the long term of healthy markers, a healthy body fat, lean body mass, a little bit of muscle, and a diet that we can stay compliant to, again, over the long term. And now, of course, I'm not saying never eat pie, I never eat cookies. Now, if we're getting some protein, some veggies, some fruits every single day over the long term, and we sneak in some pie or some Oreos, plus a healthy workout regimen, sleep, hydration, now we're talking longevity of the situation, and I believe is what's gonna be best for our health markers over the long term. Eliminating anything seems ridiculous. There was some viral YouTuber, I believe, probably 3, 4, maybe even 5 years ago now, I think, that just ate Twinkies for a year or a month, and then there was one that was literally only eating bananas. And on the internet, because people think that's absolutely ridiculous and they spite them down thinking they're morons eating just one food group or one type of food for a long term. But with the carnivore diet, because it's meat and because it's a manly thing to do in 2018, for some reason people think this is a dope idea and the guy's muscular and he lifts a lot of weights. The guy may be muscular and lift a lot of weights if he just ate one Oreo a day for a month and he might be able to even show good health markers.
But a nutrition professor lost 30 pounds eating just that. Kansas State University professor Mark Haub spent 10 weeks eating Twinkies, brownies, zebra cakes, and corn pops. He consumed no more, now this is important, he consumed no more than 1,800 calories a day.
Now, I haven't seen the movie. There's a really popular movie called Super Size Me, right? Where the guy gains weight, he gets unhealthy eating McDonald's every single day, and he has a certain barrier of rules. And I actually really enjoyed that movie, although the application of it may not be here or there. I also believe I've heard, not seen, that there's a movie where people, you know, take flexible dieting to an extreme, and a guy loses weight and improves his health markers eating McDonald's every day. You know, he might get salads or eat smaller portions or diet soda over the sugary soda, whatever it might be, and he improves his health markers. Now, I'm not saying that's correct either. What I'm saying is that probably an overall moderation balanced diet over the long term is gonna be best. We don't necessarily know. If you're going by what American society tells us, you know, over time, their markers of health and what food groups you should be eating change every 10 years. And especially changes because one, science, and two, because of political, and who knows where people are throwing money. And on a smaller scale, I truly believe that's what people are doing with any extreme diet they're trying to portray on the internet. I'm not selling you broccoli, a little bit of brown rice, and chicken for dinner a couple times a week, mixed in with some Oreos and maybe a salad, maybe even some red meat. I have nothing to sell you. But if I have a book telling you can only eat this or only eat that, and you're gonna get healthier, stronger, more testosterone, lift more weight, and be strong up until you're 75, now I might have a secret agenda on the hand where I'm trying to monetize on the back end. Don't get me wrong, I'm not against anybody making money. Everyone's gotta live, everybody's gotta eat. Everybody's got to get a roof over their head, and if you have a unique idea, I feel that you should be creative enough to run with it. But what I also think that as some type of internet source, influencer, anyone with a following, I do influencer because that word sucks. Dang, I told myself I wasn't going to curse and we dropped an F-bomb. Bleep that one out. I use this because I hate the word influencer and I dropped an F-bomb and I hate myself for not cursing. We're not cursing on this YouTube channel anymore because YouTube spited me down. I think that everyone that who's an influencer, internet has an internet following, a following in real life, obviously any kind of audience, that they have a responsibility to think of the masses and think of the general health. Now, I feel real confident telling you should probably eat a balanced diet and that we shouldn't just eliminate one food group or one type of food and especially funnel it all the way down to just eating one type of thing for longevity. Now, is there some validity to the carnivore diet? There may or may not be. Will we ever know? Probably not, because we can't, again, study the human being's diet over long term. And I'm talking about longevity. We also need to talk about what we're talking about. Are we talking about performance in the gym? How someone looks aesthetically? Health, and what does health mean? Does that maybe mean eliminating diseases or chances of diseases? Or does it mean living the longest? And which one do you really want to do? Because although some of these have some similarities, they may be different. You know, I think eating in moderation, getting your vegetables in from fresh vegetables, even raw vegetables if possible. I eat plenty of raw greens. Getting a little bit of protein in, some carbohydrates depending on your lifestyle and your macronutrient count, what your goal is, will probably be the best long term. Anybody in a calorie deficit is gonna obviously look a little bit better and their health markers will improve in the short term. I could lose weight, I could probably lose 10 pounds in a month if I just ate 3 Oreos a day. And my health markers may actually improve because I'm dropping body fat. Now, in the long term, I think everyone would say that's absolutely ridiculous, Mike, you need to get some vegetables in if you're just eating Oreos every day, now you look sickly 3 months from now. And I'm not saying that to anyone in particular, the carnivore diet, but I'm saying the potential is there. Obviously, a high protein, high fat meal is gonna be very satiating, and you can mix that into your life, but why not eat a little bit of red meat and have a little broccoli on the side? Eat a little red meat, have some kale and some rice on the side. I don't think it's that big of a deal, and it won't hurt any goals long term. I think that the conversation needs to be, why take something out? Oh, almost spilled that drink. Get a little passionate. Why take something out if it's not taken away from you, right? If I understand if someone's saying, I'm gonna eliminate caffeine for a while, I think I'm addicted to it, and it may be adding to my stress and my adrenaline receptors, blah, 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 blah. I understand why. But why take broccoli out? What negative is broccoli doing? Why take kale out? Why take out a little bit of carbohydrates if it's helping you fuel your day and you feel a little bit better and keeping you on track with your diet? What's the point of eliminating something if it may not even have a benefit. Let's say it doesn't have a benefit, but if it's not have a negative, why take it out? I understand the simplicity of the diet. You got an empty fridge with just water and meat. I get it. But I think that as humans, I don't know if we need to rely on discipline, but we should probably rely on building good habits, thinking about our choices, thinking about our actions before we do them and be able to control what we put in our body in the long term. Learning about food, learning about nutrition, learning about a well-balanced meal and lifestyle is probably gonna be your best long term. Now, that does take a little bit more effort, especially mental effort, and then just eliminating everything and I'm only gonna eat this. But I think it's gonna be well worth the wait. Man, I hope you guys like this. Comment below what topics you'd like me to cover, what we wanna talk about. Let's keep this discussion positive. I know everyone's passionate about their diets like they are their religion, but let's just keep it simple. Comment below what you want me to cover. Comment below your thoughts on the carnivore diet. Silent Mike, I'm out of here. New videos Monday, Thursday. Appreciate y'all. I'm out.